Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you the tools you need to have to take your Power BI game to the next level. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, tools. Adam, what are you talking about? You talk about tools all the time. We have talked about a lot of these in different videos and in different scenarios, but I wanted to give you a clear-cut list of what those tools are that you need to have to really get to that next level inside of Power BI. These are things that Patrick and I do and use every day in what we look at inside of Power BI, from optimization to just building the right data to getting the right items crafted for the best performance. All right, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it. Let's do what? Head over to my machine. All right, Power BI Desktop is your first tool. Of course you've got Power BI Desktop, but let's look at more. Not only just Power BI Desktop, but specifically, I wanna call out Performance Analyzer. So if you go to View, you can do Performance Analyzer, hit Start Recording, and then you can refresh the visuals and actually see the performance of what your items are doing. It gives you breakdowns of those items, and then you can copy the query and go off into other tools that we're gonna talk about. Just be mindful that there is caching that occurs inside of Power BI Desktop. So if you've already hit the report page, those numbers may look faster than they really are on the first hit. That's why I start with a blank page if I'm actually debugging it inside of Power BI Desktop, so that I can then go to the report page. So those are all tricks you can use to get the most out of that tool. Performance Analyzer is a must. Before you go deploying your report to production, you should look at this and see what's going on. Your visuals should be snappy. They shouldn't be taking a long time. If it's slow inside of Power BI Desktop, guess what? It's gonna be slow when you publish it to the service. So make sure it runs great inside of Power BI Desktop before you go to the service. All right, the next tool we're gonna look at is DAX Studio. So what can I do with DAX Studio? First, before I do that, let me go just grab a query here so we can work with something. And if you have DAX Studio installed, you'll have it as an external tool. We could see it here. I could just launch DAX Studio directly from Power BI Desktop. When I do that, it's gonna automatically connect to my model. When I'm connected here, I can do all sorts of things. First off, I can just paste that query in and I can start working with things. So I know that I'm using total sales YTD as a measure in this given item. So I could go and let's go look at total sales YTD and I can bring that in and I can start working with that measure directly in here. I can craft it. I can make sure that everything is running great. I can run server timings and I can get detailed breakdown on what is actually happening here and troubleshoot further to make sure that my items are running as fast as possible. The other cool thing that's here is you can go to the functions tab and actually get references for all the functions. And when you do that, you'll get little tooltips for what these items are for, which is nice. When you hover over measures inside of DAX Studio, you'll also get links to DAX.guide for further information on those items, just, you know, in case you need more info or you're not quite sure what that function's gonna do. So that's a great use there. The other thing that Patrick and I do all the time, whenever a customer calls us up and says, hey, we need you to look at something, something's running slow, we go to the advanced tab here and we go and get the Vertipack analyzer thing. Inside of DAX Studio, it's called metrics. So if I do view metrics, I can get all of that information, basically metadata and cardinality information, statistics about my model. Then I could also export that and send it to someone else to review if I needed to. One thing I'll give you here for export metrics, please go to file options and then advanced and then say include Tom inside of Vertipack analyzer. That way they can review the model metadata as well. That's super important. It's off by default. Please make sure you check that box. That will make Patrick and I very happy. Vertipack analyzer is one of my first stops when I'm troubleshooting performance because I can go and look and see what this model is. I key in on cardinality. I can do all sorts of things here. This is great for troubleshooting performance. I probably live in DAX Studio the most out of everything I'm gonna talk about here. Well, outside of Power BI Desktop. On to the next tool. So the next one I'm gonna do is Tabular Editor. Tabular Editor is a way just you can look at your model data. So like the actual schema of your model itself. So I can look at tables, I can look at those measures, I can do all sorts of crazy things here. So like I could go to geography key. I actually have checked the unsupported feature features. So if you go to File and you go to Preferences, there is a checkbox here. It says allow unsupported Power BI features. So there are items that are not allowed against Power BI Desktop directly, and they could change. And I'll have a link to the documentation on that in the description below. But these do work if you're going against the XMLA endpoint for either Premium per User or Power BI Premium directly. And so these are things when you get into the larger models in the enterprise space, this is going to be very important. So things like encoding hints and other items that are part of your model. But here we could also create like calculation groups. We can define perspectives. Those are all supported against Power BI Desktop. So you can still use Tabular Editor for certain things. The other big thing I'm going to call out with Tabular Editor is if I go to Tools, I can go and use best practice analyzer rules that Michael Kowalski on the Power BI CAT team put together. And I can use this as a way to see, is my model in the best shape? If I go to Manage BPA Rules, just going to add that in. I got my JSON file loaded locally, and then I can come back up to best practice analyzer and it will run all of those items. So I can collapse all of them. And then we can see here, I've got 155 objects in violation and I can go through these. The performance ones and the maintenance are probably the biggest ones I pay attention to, but you can also go through some of the formatting as well if you want it really clean and whatnot. If you don't care about formatting, you can just right click and say, ignore those rules and just work with the performance ones. When Patrick and I are troubleshooting performance, we get the Vertipack analyzer file, the VPACS file to look at the cardinality and the statistics of your model. And we also want the model itself. So that BIM file, like I showed in Vertipack analyzer, you can include the TOM model. And then we run Tabular Editor on that. And we run the best practice analyzer rules. Those are the things we do right out of the gate when we're looking to give recommendations for best practices. The next tool I want to just call out is ALM Toolkit. The ALM Toolkit's a way to compare. So a good use of this would be compare your Power BI Desktop to an actual item that's in a server somewhere. So whether this is Azure Analysis Services or Power BI Premium or Premium per User with the XMLA endpoint. And then you can compare those differences. This is great for doing, you know, diff comparisons. It's great for when you're wanting to separate development of the model in Power BI, and you want to do some of that, you know, multiple workers integration, or if you're integrating your model with source control, this is a great tool that you can check out those local changes, compare it with the destination, and then optionally choose which items you want to push to the actual server at that point. All of the items that I've talked about are just free. You can go get them. DAX Studio, Tabular Editor, ALM Toolkit. There is going to be an upcoming release of Tabular Editor, so Tabular Editor 3. As of the recording of this video, that's not out yet. There is going to be a cost associated with that, so just be aware of it. But these are the tools that we use to get up to speed. But wait, I've got a few more. Next is going to be the guidance documentation. That's right, there's guidance documentation out in the Power BI docs. So these were put together by some folks on the Power BI CAT team. Also, special shout out to Peter Myers for helping with a lot of that. You can go and get information about what these items look like, from, you know, how to reduce the size of your model to guidance around using direct query or relationship guidance. That sounds interesting. Just a ton of information there. You should be familiar with it. This is coming directly from the Power BI CAT team, which is on the Power BI product team. So lots of great information there. The other thing I want to talk about are just some books you should have on your shelves. So first up is going to be the complete reference of Star Schema, right? So this is Star Schema. Power BI likes Star Schemas, right? So you should know about Star Schemas. The next item is going to be DAX Patterns books. And there's a website out there as well, daxpatterns.com. So you can go check that out for all of just great ways to work with your data in common approaches. And then the last book you should definitely have, you know it, The Definitive Guide to DAX. This is out there. This is created from the folks over at SQL BI. So Marco Russo and Alberto Ferrari, they did DAX Patterns as well. But Definitive Guide to DAX is a must. This talks about the Vertipack engine, which is the data engine for Power BI. Talks about actually DAX itself, so you can get better with DAX. This is also so good. I have two copies just to make sure that I can really understand this, because it's that deep. Those are the tools that I have that you should have in your tool belt to make sure that you're getting the most out of Power BI and taking your models to the next level, taking your reports to the next level, and making sure that they're fast. Links for all the items down in the description below. Let me know in the comments below what you think are other items that you use in your daily usage of Power BI that help you. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.